Hello, welcome to my channel. My name is Treasure. Our today topic is self-reflection. Some of us, we only reflect on ourselves when the year is coming to an end like this. We start to count some of the things we have achieved. You know, from the beginning of January, you already like, yeah, I want to achieve this, I want to achieve this, I want to achieve this before the end of the year. I want to get married, I want to have my driving license, I want to have kids, I don't want to be in a relationship, you know. So many plans. You have, you know, figure out what you want to do for the year. And then, all through the year, you don't reflect in yourself. Only when the year is coming to an end like this, you start to reflect and counting. Yeah, normally I have like a plan to achieve this, to achieve that, and now this is what I'm able to achieve. This is what I'm able to achieve. So you start to, you know, to count all what you have achieved. And immediately after you shout Happy New Year, you forget and you start to make the same mistake you have made in the previous year. Self-reflection is very important, because when you reflect yourself, it allows you to look at your thoughts. It allows you to look at your feelings, your emotions, and actions. You often look at yourself, you know, in the mirror, and you are familiar with your outward appearance. That is how we have to be familiar with our inner self. Even some of us, we don't know what we want. We don't know who we are. We don't know why we do what we do. So you have to ask yourself, why do you do what you do? Why are you behaving the way you are behaving? Why are you in that marriage? Are you there? Are you in that marriage because people are getting married? Is it traditional stuff, or because your parents are forcing you, or the societies are pushing you, are forcing you? That is why you go into a marriage, or you want to be in a marriage to build a home, to stay under a man, to have your own family that you called your own. So why? If you know, you are able to reflect in the why you are in that marriage. The man will not be abusing you. You are still there. He beat you today. Tomorrow he come back to apologize. You accept him. And then next tomorrow again, he beat you again. The next day he come to apologize. If you reflect in yourself, in that marriage, you will know the right thing to do and the right time to leave that marriage. Or are you waiting there for him to kill you first? That is when you need self-reflection. Or are you still single at 38? You still have a whole list of the kind of men you want. At 38, you are still looking for a very lanky, tall man, educated, speak good English, from good family at 38. That is when you have to reflect on that list again. You are looking for a rich man. You have to know that not everybody is destined to marry a rich man. If you believe in yourself, you love yourself, you will not be looking for riches. You know how that man has suffered to build that wealth. Why can't you suffer and build your own like that? At 38, at 40, you are still looking for God to speak to you, to tell you, yeah, your husband is this, your husband is that. Meanwhile, God has given you a common sense to search for what the kind of man you can stay with. The other day I was talking to a lady, and she's quite old. By now she should be in a marriage. and asked her, why are you still single? She told me, I don't want to just jump into any marriage and allow the man to kill me. So why you have to first of all look for a man that will kill you? You have your common sense. God have given you your common sense. If you say you are a Christian and you pray all day, you go to church and you allow the pastors to see vision for you, you should be able to have, and when you read your Bible very well, you'll be able to know when God is speaking to you to get married. Not after waiting till 40 years and it's late for you, and then you jump into any kind of man you want, and then you are not happy there, then you start to jealous, you start to hate, you start to be sad for another person who is happy in his marriage. You begin to say, I wish I am the one who is that in that person's shoe. Why you have to be in that person's shoe? Do you know how that person have suffered? Do you know how that person have, what the person have take, the risk? You are not willing to take a risk. You are looking for God to, you are waiting for God to speak to you. So it's high time you reflect in your list again. You have to know what works for you. Not everybody is destined to marry a rich man. Are you in that marriage because you are even quitting that marriage because the man is not giving you a whole lot of money? It's high time to reflect in yourself. Or are you still in that, you have a whole lot of friends. You are not making any progress. The whole year you don't make any progress. If you tell them anything, you never make progress. You never achieve that dream. They jealous you, they heavy you. They only want to use you. They don't want you to use them because they think you are a fool. It's high time to move away from such cycle. A cycle you belong to and you don't move forward. They jealous you, they heavy you. What are you doing with such, doing in such environment, in such cycle? It's high time to reflect in your friends. And tell yourself, yeah, it's high time to move away from some friends. So self-reflection, reflect yourself. Are you spending too much? Some of you want to wear human hair of 200 euro. Meanwhile, your salary is 50,000. Your salary is 100,000. You want to wear human hair of 800,000. You want to be like Iniedo. You want to be like Regina Daniel. You don't know Regina Daniel have started somewhere. Why are you competing? Life is not a competition. Our destinies are different. Our dreams are different. Our sacrifice, our risk are different. So stop competing. Reflect in yourself again. So that you can, when you reflect in yourself, you'll be able to find the why. The reason why you do what you do. You'll be able to learn. You'll be able to take a bold step in order to move forward. You know, you'll be able to grow. But when you don't reflect in yourself, you can't grow, you can't learn. You don't know why you do what you are doing. You keep doing the same thing over and over again, and you keep getting the same results. So, self-reflection. It's very important. Are you laughing too much? Are you giving too much? Are you sacrificing too much and neglect yourself? Do you hate too much? Somebody offend you, refuse to forgive because you think you are a perfect person? Or you are waiting for that person to fall down so that you can laugh? It's hard time to reflect in yourself. And ask yourself the reason why you do what you do. Because when you know the reason, when you know your why, you can find a better way out. So thank you very much for your time. And I hope this topic meets you well. Thank you, and don't forget to subscribe and to click the notification bell so that whenever I upload a video, you will get notified. Stay safe and bye for now.